Hello, welcome to Yoga with Katie. Today we're going to be doing a gentle class, servo for all level. And we're just going to come to a comfortable seated position, sitting up nice and tall. Close your eyes for a moment, taking a few calming breath. When you inhale, belly and chest rise like a balloon. And when you exhale, draw the belly button back to the spine. We're staying very calm, relaxed, and still in the present moment. Setting your intention for tonight's class. And we're gonna slowly open up the eyes, inhale your arms up above the head, turn up, have our exhale down. Inhale to lengthen, exhale to release. One more, inhale, arms up, lengthening the spine, exhale down. Hands to your thighs, sitting up nice and tall. We're gonna stretch out the neck next. Ear to shoulder, extend the opposite arm out. Using the same hand, guide and support the head. Lengthening, stretch. Relieve any tension that you may have. Feel free to close your eyes and listen to my verbal instruction. We're gonna stay here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly come back to center, the other side. Ear to shoulder, extend the opposite arm out. Using the same hand, guide or support the head. If there's any clicking sound, any stiffness in your neck, just stay here for a little bit longer. One more breath, and we're gonna slowly come back to center. Take an inhale to center, exhale to work the right shoulder. Only go to where you're comfortable. Inhale, center. Exhale to the left. Slowly curl back to center, chin up, head back. And then chin to chest. Both ways we're stimulating thyroid gland. Inhale, center, exhale, look at the right armpit. 45 degree angle. Slightly tuck the chin in, looking down. Slowly curl back to center. Now we're gonna look at the other armpit. Slightly tuck the chin in, 45 degree angle. Stretch. Slowly come back to center. We're gonna look at the opposite corner of the ceiling. Chin up, looking up. Slowly release the other corner. Chin up, head back. Looking up. Stretching out different parts of your neck. Slowly come back to center. Now we're gonna do next circle, either full circle or half circle. Nice and slow and control. Don't make yourself dizzy. If there's any stiffness in your neck, just stay there for a little bit longer. When you're ready, we're gonna go into a full circle. Go at your own breath and your own pace. Not rushing yourself. One more round, and we're gonna come back to center. Take a breath here. When you're ready, we're gonna go the other way, half circle, change direction. Don't swing your head. Don't make yourself dizzy. Don't injure the soft tissues in your neck. When you're ready, go into a full circle. Once again, nice and slow. If there's any stiffness in your neck, any clicking sound, feel free to stay there for a little bit longer. Slowly come back to center to release. Shoulder stretch, right arm up and across, pull back. Creating resistance, chin is away from the body, looking forward. Pull back. One more breath. Slowly release. Same arm up. We lengthen first. Place the palm behind your back. Use the other hand to guide the elbow, tricep stretch, chin up, looking forward. If you can bind hands behind your back, go ahead, binding hands behind your back. One more breath, and we're gonna slowly, slowly release. Shake it out, the other side. Shoulder stretch first, arm up and across, pull back, creating resistance. Chin is away from the body, looking forward. Slowly release, same arm up, lengthen first, place the palm behind your back. Use the other hand to guide the elbow. Try to bring the elbows to the back of your head. If you can bind hands behind your back, go ahead. Don't worry if you're not able to do this. Everybody has different ability, different body type. Now we're gonna slowly, slowly release when you have enough of it. Shake it out. Hands on the shoulders, elbows in, elbows up. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Further pinch your shoulder blades. Opening up lung, heart, chest. Helping people with breathing related issues. Improving your posture. Oiling the shoulder joint. So we're gonna do it 5 times. Once you're done, we're gonna go into a full circle. Try to bring the elbows close together. Continue with shoulder exercise. And reverse. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Forearm stretch. Palm facing me, fingers facing down. Lengthening the forearm. Opening up energy channel. Stimulating meridian point, acupuncture point. Keep your blood and your chi circulating throughout the body. And we're gonna change direction. Palm facing me, fingers facing up. Back of the hand facing me, fingers facing down. Change direction, back of the hand facing me, fingers facing up. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out, the other side. Forearm stretch, palm facing me, fingers facing down. Now, if you have very tight forearm or if you're very fragile, you're not able to straighten out, just have a slight bend at the elbow. You can always adapt, modify, adjust to suit your needs and your body type. Now we're gonna change direction, palm facing me, fingers facing up. Back of the hand facing me, fingers facing down. Back of the hand facing me, fingers facing up. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. Wrist rotation, we're gonna do 10 times one way, 10 times reverse. Nice and slow here. Once you've done 10 times, change direction. Forward, backwards, backing up. Thumb up, forward, backwards. Change leg arms, give it a shake. And shake, shake, shake. Be gentle with your body, always. Never push yourself beyond your limits and your boundaries. Slowly, slowly release. Hands on your thighs. Sitting up nice and tall. We're gonna come to a side bend. Inhale your arms up, palm touch, release index finger, grow tall. Exhale, bend towards the right side. Bending the lower arm, top arm is the crescent moon. Get a little bit deeper in your side bend. Chin is away from the body, looking up. Slowly, slowly come back to center. We lengthen the center. Exhale, we're gonna bend towards the other side. Bending the lower arm. Top arm is a crescent moon. Make sure both butts are sitting down. Now we're slowly, slowly coming back up. And we'll give ourselves a hug. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder. Wrap the back arm around your waist. Keep turning, overlooking your shoulder, looking at the back. Turning the neck as well. Stretching our lower back muscles. Massaging internal organs. Helping you to digest and detox. Couple more breath. And we're gonna slowly come back to center. Inhale, arms up, lengthening the spine, exhale, twist. Give yourself a hug. Opposite hand, opposite shoulder. Wrap the back arm around your waist. Keep turning, overlooking your shoulder. Look at the back, turning the leg as well. All twisting position. Help you to relieve back pain. Two more breath. One more. We're gonna slowly come back to center. Inhale, arms up, lengthening, exhale, twist. Opposite hand, opposite thigh. Turn and look at the back. Not leaning back too much. Using the exhale breath to turn a little bit more. One more breath. Slowly come back to center. Don't let go of the front hand. Inhale the other arm up. Forming a crescent, looking up. Slowly, slowly release. Repeat on the other side. Opposite hand, opposite thigh. The other arm up and over. Bring it directly behind your spine. Keep turning. Overlooking your shoulder. Looking at the back. Turning the neck as well. One more breath here. We're going to slowly bring the body back to center. Don't let go of the front hand. Inhale the other arm up. Forming a crescent, looking up. Slowly, slowly release. Hands on your thighs, sitting up nice and tall. We're going to come to a torso turn. So starting our small circle. Gradually do a deeper and deeper torso turn. Moving your shoulders as well. Warming up the spine. When you're in the center position, we're going to go the other way, reverse, touching all four corners of your space, warming up the spine. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Inhale your arms up to lengthen. Exhale, bow down. Walking the fingers forward, elbows off the mat. Shoulders relaxed, forehead down. Lengthening the spine. Keeping your spine and your neck in one straight line. We're gonna stay here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna walk both hands to the right side as far as you can go. Feel the stretch in the side of your body. Slowly, slowly walking back to the center and then walk over to the other side as far as you can go. Feel the length in the side of your body. One more breath. Slowly walking the hands back to the center. And walk the hands towards you. And we're gonna place the hand down, finger facing you. And we're gonna lean back. Stretching out the forearm, the wrist, a little bit of discomfort. So you listen to your body on this one. One more breath. Slowly, slowly come back up. Now we're gonna come to a neutral tabletop. Getting ready for cat and cow. Spread all your fingers, wrists underneath the shoulder, knees underneath the hip, top of feet on the mat, neutral spine. When you're ready, we're gonna go into cat and cow. Inhale, drop your belly, chin up, look up into a cow.
Exhale, round your back as much as you can. Pull your belly tight, looking down into a cat. So inhale one way, exhale the other. Connecting your breath with your movement. Creating spaces between water breaks. Cat and cow also help people to relieve back pain. Two more times. And one last one. Slowly, slowly come back to neutral, swaying side to side, release tension in the wrist. Take an inhale to center, exhale to open up the right hip, squeeze the shoulder and hip together. Let the hip drop. Inhale, center. Exhale to the other side, forming a C shape in your spine. One more set. Inhale, center. Exhale to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale to the left. Slowly, slowly come back to neutral, swaying side to side. Coming to thread the needle. Inhale the right arm up. Exhale, side through the opening, dropping the right shoulder down. Left arm can be out in front of you or wrapped around your waist. Beginners, you can stay here. If you want to put more body weight on the shoulder, extend the left leg out on your toes or off the mat. Any variation you like. Don't worry about lifting the back leg if you find that this is challenging to balance. Just be mindful if anyone who has any shoulder issues, injuries, surgeries, or frozen shoulder. One more breath. Slowly, slowly release. Using the left hand to push yourself up. And we're going to repeat on the other side. Inhale the left arm up. Exhale, slide through the opening, dropping the left shoulder down. Right arm can be out in front of you or around your waist. Now you can stay here if you like and extend right leg up on your toes or off the mat. Any variation you like to chant this out. Putting more body weight on the left shoulder. So don't worry about the back leg if you find that it is challenging for you tonight. One more breath. Slowly, slowly release. Using the right hand to push yourself up. And we're going to continue in kneeling. We're going to inhale, arms up, sit down on your heels. So we're going to inhale up, exhale down. Now, if you have very tight ankle joints, and if you're not able to sit on your ankle, no problem. Engage your core abdominal muscles while you're doing this. In another word, squeeze your stomach in tight. Continue to work on your quadricep, the big muscles. Use your core abdominal muscles to bring you up and down. Let's do two more. And one last one. Slowly, slowly release. Toe stretch, all 10 toes touching the floor. Sit back on your heels. Once again, if you have very tight ankle joint, toe joint, if you are not able to sit on your heel, no problem. You can sit on your block. That will raise your hip up a little bit, taking some pressure off. And we're gonna go into Eagle Arm. Inhale the arms up, right and the left. Big, big hug, love yourself. Now you can stay here. You can lock the elbows, grab hold of the thumb. Go ahead, lifting the elbows up and away from the body, forming an L shape. Eagle Arm, while we're doing toe stretch. Staying here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly release. Come to a neutral tabletop. Tap, tap, tap.
Swaying side to side, release any tension that you may have. And now we can sit back on our ankle, stretching out the ankle joints. So once again, if this is very tight and uncomfortable for you, you can also sit on the block. And we're gonna go eagle arm on the other side. Inhale the arms up, the other arm underneath. Block the elbows, grab a hold of the thumb, lift the elbows up and away from the body, form an L shape. Eagle arm on the other side. Staying here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly release those who are on the block. Remove your block. And we're going to come back to neutral tabletop. Tap, tap, tap. Release any tension that you may have. Swaying side to side. And we're going to slowly transition to come lie down on your stomach for back extension. So take your time to come lie down on your stomach. Hands by your chest, forehead down. Legs are hip width apart, top of the feet on the mat. When you're ready, lift the hand chest up, hands off, kneecaps up. Looking down to protect your neck. And we're gonna stay here for 5 breaths. Strengthening the lower back muscles to support your spine, especially if you have back pain. Couple more breaths. And we're gonna slowly and gently release everything down. Extend your arms forward, coming into your Superman. Forehead down, kneecaps up. When you're ready, lift the hand chest up, arms off, making thigh off, looking down. Keeping your neck and your spine in one straight line. Strengthening the lower back muscles to support the spine, especially if you have back pain. 2 more breaths. And then we're going to slowly and gently release everything down. Coming into your locus, strain your arm behind your back. If you can interlace the finger, go ahead. Modification of locus, arm by your side, not touching your body. When you're ready, lifting the hand chest up. If you can, leg and thigh off, looking down. Staying here for 5 breaths. Two more breaths. And we're gonna slowly and gently release everything down. Arms out in T, palm facing down, coming into a proper dog. Legs are apart as wide as the mat. Left cheek on the mat. Bending the right knee. Draw it close to the right elbow. Make yourself completely flat. As we stretch out the left side of your neck and opening up the right hip. Relax. Make yourself comfortable. Couple more breaths. And we're gonna slowly bring everything back to the center. Stack your hands on top of each other, bend both knees, windshield wiper. You can either have chin down or forehead down. Feel the slight movement in your lower back. Swaying side to side. Listen up. So all the poses lying down on the stomach will help you to strengthen lower back muscles to support your spine. Slowly coming back to center to release. Now we're gonna come to grab a hold of one ankle, both ankle, take the foot into your hand. Now if you cannot do both ankle, extend the opposite arm out. So opposite arm, opposite ankle. And those who can, grab a hold of both ankle, bottom of your feet towards the sky. Don't open up the thigh too much.
Lifting the hand chest up, thigh off if you can. Now, if this is too late in the evening that you don't want to rock forward, backward, side to side, go ahead. You listen to your body always to avoid injuries. And those who are doing one arm at a time, after a few breaths, switch side. One more breath here. And then we're gonna slowly, slowly release everything down. Coming into a seal, legs are mat width apart. Spread out your fingers, come up on your forearms. Elbows within shoulders reach. Chin is away from the body, looking forward. You can stay here. If you like, you can push yourselves up some more to the hand level. If this is too much for you, too intensive, causing you a whole lot of pain and discomfort, please come back down on your forearm. Shoulders are relaxed, eyes looking forward. Couple more breaths here, and we're gonna slowly, slowly release. Coming to crocodile on the other side, legs are already apart, mat width, right cheek on your mat, bending the left knee. Draw it close to the left elbow. Make yourself completely flat. As we stretch out the right side of your neck and opening up the left hip. Couple more calming breath, and we're gonna slowly, slowly bring everything back to the center of the mat. Stack your hands on top of each other, legs are hip width. Wiggle your butt side to side, loosen up. So once again, you can either have chin down or forehead down. Slowly, slowly release. To counter back extension, we're gonna go into a child pose. Push yourself up, knees apart, big toes to touch. Sink the hip down onto the heels, walking the fingers forward, elbows off the mat. Shoulders are relaxed, forehead down. Try to sit back as much as you can. If you have very tight ankle or hip joint, rest your forehead on stacked hands, stack this. Try to sit back as much as you can. One more breath, and we're gonna slowly, slowly release. Getting ready to come up. So we're gonna meet you in down dog. Take your time, spread all your fingers, tuck your toes. Lift your hips high, high up. Coming into a down dog. Upside down, letter B. Pushing the mat away. Release the head down. Walking the dog out by alternating, bending your knees. Stretching out the toes. Mountain climbing. Inhale to come up on your tippy toes, stretching out the toes. Exhale to lower the heel back down. One more time. Inhale, up, up, up on your toes. Exhale down. Inhale, come forward to a high plank. Wrists underneath the shoulder, toes underneath the heels. Exhale to down dog. One more. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale to down dog. Slowly walk forward towards the hands. And now we're in the forward bend. All 10 toes facing the front, legs are hip width.
If you can touch the mat. If you cannot touch the mat, hold on to opposite elbows or behind the legs. Hip bones above ankle bones. Let your stomach rest on your thighs. Let the blood go the other way for a moment. As we lengthen the spine, stretching out lower back muscles. So active forward bend is also a good one to do to relieve back pain. Gently shake yes with the head. Gently shake no. Now we're gonna get ready to come up. Hands on waist for support. Inhale halfway up to a flat back. Exhale to slowly, slowly rise up to standing. Let your blood pressure get adjusted. Up the forward bend, we're gonna go back bend to counter. So interlace the finger behind. Knuckles down and away from you. Not pushing the hips forward. Shoulders and hips are level. Chin is away from the body. Looking up. Feel the pancreas shoulder blades. Opening up lung, heart, chest. Helping people with breathing related issues. Improving your posture. Stimulating thyroid gland by lifting chin up and head back. One more breath. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Getting ready for sun salutation. So top of your mat, big toes to touch. Align the edge of your feet to the edge of your mat. Listen to your body always to avoid injuries. Inhale, your arms up, back bend. Exhale, forward bend. Inhale, halfway up to a flat back. Exhale, hands on mat. Stepping back into a plank. Shifting the weight forward. Beginners can drop to your knees. Tuck your elbow by your side, you can dip. Inhale, cobra is modification. Or up dog. Shoulders relax. Eyes looking up. Exhale, you can fall back on your knees. Tuck your toes. Lift your hips high, high up. Coming into a down dog. We're gonna stay here for 5 rounds. Spread all your fingers. Middle index finger facing forward. Separate your feet 2 fists apart, not too wide, not too narrow. Release the head down. Align your knees by your inner arms. Eyes are located your toes, knees or belly button. Now we look between the hands, step or hop to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway up to flat back. Exhale, forward bend. Slightly bend the knees. Inhale, your arms all the way up. Back bend. And then arm down by your side. Into a mountain pose. Now we're going to sun salutation B. Inhale, your arms up. Sit in your chair. Exhale, forward bend. Inhale, halfway up to a flat back. Exhale, hands on mat. Step or jump back into a plank. Shifting the weight forward. Chaturanga is all one breath. Inhale, cobra or dog. Exhale, to down dog. Take your time to set up. Shoulders are external rotation. Elbows are internal rotation. Eye of the elbow facing each other. Feel free to walk the dog out by alternating, bending your knees like mountain climbing. Coming into warrior one on the right side. Inhale, right foot forward towards the right hand. Left foot at 45. Heel to heel, heel to arch. Arms up. Palm facing each other. Pinky slightly curved in. Shoulders relaxed down from the knees. Eyes looking up. Front knee is 90 degrees on top of the ankle. Back leg is straight. Now we're going to windmill the hands back down the mat. Stepping back into your plank. Shifting the weight forward. Chaturanga. Inhale, cobra. Up dog. Exhale, to down dog.
Take your time to set up,
lifting the hips high, high up, pushing the mat away. Release the head down. Shifting half of the weight towards the legs to minimize impact on the wrist. Warrior one on the left side. So inhale, left foot forward towards the left hand. If you cannot step, so to make step, use your left hand to guide the leg. Arms up, holding onto your ball. Sink down. Front knee still 90 degree on top of the ankle. Back leg at 45. Heel to heel or heel to arch. Shoulders relaxed down from the knees. Eyes looking up. Now we're going to windmill the hands back down the mat. Stepping back into a plank. Shifting the weight forward. Lower down. Elbows lower than the shoulders. Don't flop them. Inhale, cobra, up dog. Exhale, to down dog. Go your own breath and your own pace, lifting the hips high, high up, pushing the mat away. One more breath, look between the heads, step the hop to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway up to flat back. Exhale, forward bend. Inhale your arms, sit in your chair. Raising your heels, you can see your toes, look at your toes. Don't push the knee beyond your toes. Strong arms, strong core, work the legs. And then we're gonna power out with the strong legs. Back bend, and down by your side. Into a mountain pose. Stay in the mountain pose, legs are your work apart. Arms by your side, palm facing forward, soft knees. Close your eyes for a moment. Slowing down your heartbeat. Make a fist. Inhale, shoulders up to your ears. Make it tight, tight, tight. Sign it out to release. Again, inhale, shoulders up. Creating a lot of tension. Exhale, let it go. Two more times. Inhale, your shoulders up. Lots and lots of tension. Exhale, one last one. Inhale, shoulders up. Shake it out. Coming into balancing. So have a sip of water if needed. Come to the center of your mat. My left is your right, heel down first. Spread the toes, sink the big toe down. Shift the weight through the standing leg. Turn the other knee out to the side of the room, coming into tree, toe down, calf high, half lotus or hook behind, anywhere but the knee joint. Bring your hands to heart center. Take an inhale first, exhale, rise up, lengthening the spine. Inhale, exhale, open up the branches. Shoulders relax down from the ears, eyes looking forward. Digging the heel into standing leg pushing the heel back. Shoulders are relaxed. Tall and strong like a tree. Engage your core, abdominal muscles. One more breath. And then we're going to slowly bring the hands together. Two, release. Shake it out, alternating bending your knees. Shift the weight to the other side, heel down first, spread the toes, grab the mat, sink the big toe down. And then when you're ready, turn the other knee out to the side of the room, toe down, calf, thigh, half lotus, anywhere but the knee joints. Bring your hands to heart center. Take an inhale first. Exhale, rise up, lengthening the spine. Inhale, exhale, open up the branches. Shoulders are relaxed, chin is away from the body. Eyes looking at a focal point, either on the floor or at the horizon. If you want to challenge yourself, look up at the sky or close your eyes. Feel the energy within you, tall and strong like a tree. Now we're going to slowly bring the hands together to release. And we're going to come to seated. Bring the soles of your feet together. Wrap your hands around your ankle. Sitting up nice and tall, rocking side to side, finding your sitting bones. Fly like a butterfly, flap about 10 times, opening up hip joint. Draw the heel close to you. Grab a hold of the big toes on the entire feet. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale, we hinge forward, kneeling with the chest. Bring the arms on the outside of the shin. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold. Neck is long, spine is straight. Do not round the back or drop the head or become a hunchback. We have to open up the hip joint before we can go any further. A little bit of discomfort as we stretch out the inner thighs. Slowly, slowly come back to center. I'm gonna wish to wiper. Keep your knees bent. This is hip width. Hands behind you, finger facing the same way as your feet. Dropping the knees from one side to the other side. Let it fall wherever it falls. Hips can come off. Knees don't necessarily have to touch the mat. Hip release. Now we're going to open up and drop both knees to the right side. Forming a 90 degree. If you want a smaller ankle, if you're less flexible, go ahead. Make sure your butt stay down. The stretch is here, quadricep hip joints. Look at the opposite side. Staying here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly come back to center and we're gonna windshield wiper a few more times. Release any tension that you may have. And we're gonna open up and drop both knees to the other side. So let it fall wherever it falls. But stay down, you should feel the stretch here, quadricep hip joint. Looking at the opposite side. A little bit of discomfort. So listen to your body on this one. One more breath. Slowly, slowly release. Come back to center. Straighten out the legs. Arms in a few times. Get the fleshy part out from your butt. Getting ready for double leg forward bend. So we are in the start pose. Toes are pointed up to the ceiling. Shoulders on top of hips. Stomach and chest proud. Inhale your arms up to lengthen. Exhale, we hinge forward, kneeling on the chest. Grow longer. Pressing your hands maybe beyond your feet. Holding on to any part of the feet, the legs, or release the hands on either side. If you want to use your yoga strap, go ahead. Feel free to use yoga accessory to help you get into the alignment. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to fold. Now, chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. Not dropping the head or rounding the back. So we have to pay attention to our alignment. Neck is long, spine straight. And we have to hinge from the hips to bring the stomach a little bit closer. One more breath here. And we slowly, slowly release. Coming into one leg forward bend. My left is your right. Point the toes up to the ceiling. Inhale your arms up to lengthen. Exhale, we hinge forward, grow longer. Body's directly on top of the straight leg. Holding on to any part of the foot, the legs, or release the hands on either side. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. When you come down, stomach come down first. Chest, head is the last thing. So we're not doing head to knee. Make sure you are coming down in one unit. Once again, if you're using yoga strap, you're not yanking yourself to come down. This is just to help you get into the alignment. Walking with your breath always. Inhale is the lengthening breath to prepare. Exhale, in this case, is to fold. Slowly, slowly come back up. Coming into seated twist, bring the bending on the outside of the straight leg. Begin to stay here. Make sure both butts are sitting down. Opposite arm, opposite. Draw it close to you. Sit up tall. The other arm up and over. Bring it directly behind your spine. Wrap the right in your waist.
Keep turning, overlooking your shoulder. Looking at the back, turning the neck as well. And we're staying here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly bring the body to the opposite side. Bow down, counter twist. Bending the elbows, more room to come down. As we stretch our lower back and oblique the side of your body. One more breath. Slowly, slowly pushing yourself back up. Straighten out the legs. Bounce it a few times. Now we're going to repeat. One leg forward bend on the other side. Point your toes up to the ceiling. Inhale your arms up to lengthen. Exhale. Hinging from the hips so the entire unit comes down. Pretty soon your hands will be beyond your foot. Holding onto any part of the foot, the legs. So release the hands on either side. If you're using yoga strap, go ahead. Using your yoga strap to help you get into the alignment. Neck is long, spine is straight. One more breath. Slowly, slowly release. See the twist, bring the bending on the outside of the straight leg. If you can bend long leg, go ahead. Both butts down, both feet on the ground. Opposite arm, opposite knee. Draw it close to you. Sit up tall. The other arm up and over. Bring it directly behind your spine, around the waist. Front arm can be stop sign hand or prayer hands. Any variation you like. Keep turning, overlooking your shoulder. Looking at the back. Stretching our lower back muscles, massaging internal organs, helping you to digest and detox. One more breath. Slowly bring the body to the opposite side. Bow down, counter twist. Bending the elbows, more room to come down as we stretch our lower back and oblique the side of your body. One more breath. Slowly, slowly coming back up. Straighten out the legs. Bounce it a few times. We're going to get ready to come lie down on your back. So take your time. Come lie down on your back. Bend your knees. Your spine will automatically release. Keeping the natural curve in your lower back. Arm down by your side. Palm facing down. All lying down poses, we are slightly tucking the chin in to protect your neck. Not to say that the chin is touching the chest. Close your eyes for a moment. And if you happen to be lying down underneath a light, try to move a few inches over so the light is not directly on you. We're going to go into the bridge pose, so keep your knees bent. Your knees are 2 fists apart, don't open up too much. Walk the heel close to your fingertips. Those who wish to squeeze the block, go ahead. Place the block comfortably between your thighs. Press firmly on the mat. On the inhale, we're going to lift the hips high, high up. Roll the shoulder in underneath your bridge. Interlace the fingers, pull the knuckles towards the heels. Keeping your hips high up, we're strengthening the front abdominal muscles, your quadricep, and your glutes. In another word, squeeze your stomach in tight, your thighs and your butt are firm. And we're going to stay here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice and slow control. We're going to release the spine back down. Once you come all the way down, remove your block. Where's your wiper? Drop the knees from one side to the other side. Let it fall wherever it falls.
Hip release. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Straighten out the legs. Bounce it a few times. Wind releasing on the right side. Wrap your hands around the right knee. Draw it close to the chest or armpit. Give it a good squeeze. Massage your organs on the right side as well as the ascending corner. Point the left toes up to the ceiling so both legs are working. Right hand on right knee. Using a gentle circular motion, massaging the right hip joint. So once again, five times one way, five times reverse. Slowly come back to center. Spinal twist, right foot on left thigh. Opposite hand, opposite thigh. Slowly guide the top knee. As close to the floor as possible. Right arm on shoulder height, arm facing down. If your neck is good, turn and look at the right side. Hips automatically comes off. Stretch, strengthen, and tone the lower back muscles to support your spine, especially if you have back pain. One more breath here. We're going to slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs. Bounce it a few times. Point the right toes up to the ceiling. Grab your hands around the left knee. Draw it close to the chest or armpit. Gently pump it a few times. Inhale, relax. Exhale, squeeze. Massaging organs on the left side as well as descending colon. Anytime you feel bloated, constipated, feel free to do this pose when releasing, either on the floor or in your bed or sitting down on a chair. Now we come to spinal twist, left foot on right thigh, opposite hand, opposite thigh. Slowly guide the top knee as close to the floor as possible. Feel free to extend the top leg if you have room. Left arm on shoulder height, arm facing down. Turn it over the left side, your neck is good. Stretching our lower back muscles, creating spaces between L4 and L5, helping you to relieve back pain. One more breath, and we're going to slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs, bounce it a few times. Bend both knees, wrap your hands around your knees, rocking side to side. Coming into a big circular motion if you like, covering a big area. Massaging lower back and sacrum, also helping you to relieve back pain. Change direction, go the other way. Slowly come back to center, lift your feet up to the sky. Come into a happy baby. Bend both knees, hands on the bottom of your feet. Press down so that the knees are close to the armpits, rocking side to side. Opening up the hip joint, stretching out inner thighs. Massaging the entire back. Slowly come back to center. Open up your legs in the big V. Grab a hold of the big toes or any part of the legs. Continue to rock side to side. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Bring your legs together, hands behind your kneecap, flex the feet. Let the blood circulate back to your heart. Stretch your hamstrings. Improve overall wellness. Increase immunity, digestion, and improve your sleep quality. One more breath, I'm down by your side. Take your time to nicely come down or control. Don't just swing the leg up and down, use your abs. Once you come all the way down, bounce it a few times. Bring the sole of your feet together, let the knee fall to form a diamond shape. I'm down by your side, palm facing down. Close your eyes for a moment. Let gravity does its job to open up hip joints, slowing down the heartbeat. Then we'll draw the knees together, drop them to the right side, raise your right arm, roll over to the right side, making a pillow of the right tricep, coming into a fetus position. And when you're ready, use your top arm to push yourself up. And we're going to come to a comfortable seated position. Taking our three final closing breath here. So bring your hands to heart center. Inhale to bring the arms forward. Exhale to open up nice and slow, gathering energy from each other. Inhale your arms up above the head, palm touch. Exhale down, sending the energy back to you. Again, inhale, arms forward. Exhale to open. Inhale your arms all the way up, palm touch. Exhale down. One last one, inhale your arms forward. Exhale to open, feel the tingling and warm in your palms. Inhale your arms up above the head, palm touch. Exhale down. To close the practice, bring the thumb to the third eye or in front of your heart. Thank you very much for watching, sharing your energy with all of us, and letting me guide through this practice. Always my pleasure. Namaste. Thank you.